Get it. Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah.
He's a monster.
Look at him.
Get the net. Get him in the net, baby. Oh, I can't get it. Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Whoa.
Get out, crappie.
Look at that, baby.
Oh, my goodness, Tim. Welcome to the land of monster crappie, good old Mississippi. This special episode features a few of the incredible road trips to good old Miss, as we feature Lake Washington from Greenville, Mississippi on this episode. Let's get started with trip number 3.
You know, here on Lake Washington, we're early spring, early March, and we've really struggled to try to pattern these crappie. One reason why they're really scattered, you know, catch one here and catch one there. And when we run into those conditions, we always alternate our baits. You know, we start on this pole, you know, this one might be, you know, 6 inches from the bottom, and this one might be a little bit higher, and this one might be, you know, middle depth. If we're in 8 foot of water, we might have this one at 4 foot, and this one might be just 18 or 20 inches under the water. And again, we haven't been able to pattern a fish, so we just catch one here and there in different depths. So, you know, we always use different depths when we're not really hooked in on where the fish are. So that'd be a good tip to remember, especially early in the spring. Vary your depths of the bait you're using.
What you got there, buddy?
Crap.
Look at this.
He's hanging around near the pole, I think, too. Is he?
Good fish.
Hey. First fish of the day. What happens when the day after the tournament? Hey. Day after the tournament, me and Tim decide to stick around. First fish. That's how they're supposed to look on Lake Washington. Round. Not long. Round. You know why? Because they're so fat and big. Fun. That's what I like, man. Look at that. Beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful Lake Washington crappie. Say hello to the camera, crappie. Huh? Say hello. Hello. We'll put them in the box. Get a few. You have some. Another crappie meal. Huh?
Well, we had a second day in Greenville, so me and Tim decided we're going to stay on Lake Washington and have some fun. And lo and behold, first fish we get, bigger than all the ones we get in the Big Mama. Isn't that the way it goes?
You know, today this is early springtime, and every year in the spring, we always break out the 16-foot B&M Bucks graphite jig poles. Fishermen know them as BGJPs. They're 16 foot long, and the reason why we use those, a lot of times in the spring, we're fishing really shallow. We want to get these poles way out in front of the boat where your troll motor, your electronics, and boat noise don't spook the fish.
Like that, you mean?
That's quick.
Hey? Oh, yeah.
That's a net job.
Yeah. They're getting rounder. They're getting fatter. Oh, boy, yep. I'll throw them in the box for you. Beautiful fish. That's the way. I'll put that right there for a little second. The black man called Blackley. Redemption. One he had was about that much longer, that much thicker, that much higher. But we're still catching crappie and we're having fun. Lake Washington.
You know, when we're spider fishing, speed is very important. It seems like the key, 1st of March and early March when it's really cold, we want to stay 0.1 to 0.3, you know, really slow troll. And a lot of times, especially in the spring, you have a lot of wind. And that hinders you when you're trying to maybe go with the wind. So a lot of times we use our drift paddles. We'll put them down, and if you're going, say, a mile an hour and you're drifting a mile an hour, it'll cut your speed in half. And it's been a very important factor, especially Thursday when we got here. We had about a 10, 15 mile an hour wind. We put our paddles down, and they worked really good.
Boy, I can't believe that didn't come off.
Huh?
Well, you boogie.
You saw that? Hey?
Did I see it?
It's like, that fish is meant to be in the boat, huh? The buggy whip him. No kidding. Well, come here.
Good one, boys, good one.
Look at that thing, huh? Look at that thing. Look where that hook is. Tim made a comment too that that fish, look at the slice on the side there. You see that? Look where the hook just made that slice through there. If that fish would have thrashed on the surface and stuff, that's what would have happened. And then I would have been heartbroken. But I got lucky on that one, dudes, right there. That one's going into the box. Nice Lake Washington crappie. Give you a kiss, and later we're gonna munch down. Okay, let's go in the box. And there's another Washington crappie. The day after the tournament. Isn't that the way it goes? The day after the tournament, it doesn't matter. You know what? Come to Mississippi, here in Greenville, catching crappie, I'm just having fun, man. Look at it, it's slick. They say it's gonna storm later on, but who cares? You know, I got the rain gear on. I'm fishing in March, open water and having fun. And you can be here too. Consider Greenville, Mississippi, because Lake Washington, they've got some good crappie.
You know, we're here on Lake Washington here, first weekend of March. And today, what we used were B&M, Buck's Graphite Jig Poles, BGJPs. They're 16 foot long. We use a 6 pound line. And you know, we've looked and searched for years for a reel that matched the rods. B&M makes a great rod. And just this year, we've developed and come out with a B&M reel. It's a little 5 ball bearing spinning reel. Combination is great with this Buck's Graphite pole. And for bait, just about all of our fish this weekend come on a 1/2 ounce B&M Minnow Rig. It's a Caps and Coleman design. They come in pre-wrapped, ready to go. Come in a little pack. You get 6 of them in a pack, and they're ready to go. We get asked all the time, you know, what do y'all do when y'all get them out of the pack? We put them on our line. There's no need to modify them. They've been proven. They're set up perfect. And that was our combination at work this week.
Come on, crappie. Show us what you got. Come on. Let's make that net wet.
You know, we're in the ground, we're not getting a lot of bites, and then all of a sudden, bam, my pole tip goes down, I reach and grab it, and it's a pretty good sized fish, the biggest one we had on the whole time we were here. I holler for the net. Net, where's Carl? He must be on a coffee break.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Ooh-wee. That was one of those.
That's 2.5.
Yeah, dude. Hey, see what he came up with like this?
See what happens when you hesitate? I wanted to see how big that fish was first that Tim had, but you know what? Too slow with the net. All I hear was Tim was beep, fish gone. Biggest fish of the 3 days on Lake Washington. Oops, sorry, Tim.
Okay, that was just a teaser for what's to come on the next road trip to Lake Washington. Now this segment features some of the freaks of this lake. It's foggy, it's cold, but I want to catch crappie.
You know, Carl called, he's wanting to come south, get out of that cold up in Canada. I picked him up in Memphis, headed to Lake Washington in Mississippi. We met some more cold weather down there. We got there, temperatures were cold, we were bundled up, wearing gloves, hats, toboggans.
Week before, the guys are just smashing crappie. I get here, it's jacket, insulated pants, long underwear, gloves, all day. What's up with that?
Water temperature is 45 degrees. A week ago we was here, it was 55. So, you know, it's putting them in a holding pattern. They should be out here in a little bit deeper water, so that's where we're gonna give them a try. And hopefully have a good day.
Now, you know Tim knows how to find crappie. It doesn't matter where it is in the United States. So I'm relying on him. Remember, I'm the co-captain. I'm watching the rods, making sure the line's not jumping up, going to the right, going to the left.
Today we're gonna use B&M Caps and Coleman Minnow Rigs on some 1/8 ounce and 1/4 ounce jig heads, just to try to find out what the bite is, what they're looking for, if they're wanting something a little bit smaller like a minnow or something larger. Take us a couple hours to figure that out. Once we get dialed in, we'll probably switch all to one bait, either minnows or jigs, so we'll see how that goes.
Netter, Tim?
Yeah.
Atta boy, Tim. Lake Washington crappie. Well, that's a nice one, eh?
Big white, big female.
First Lake Washington fish, Tim. What do you think of that?
2 pound fish.
First live well fish of the day?
Yeah.
Can I hold it?
Nice fish.
You see what a nice guy? He lets me hold it. He caught it. First Lake Washington crappie of the year. In a box. Fat bellied crappie. Come on.
You know, at these lakes, especially down in Mississippi, for some reason these fish position themselves up high in the water column. We see it all the time. You know, it might be 10 foot deep. We might just be fishing 12 inches on the surface. Fish are like us. They want to be comfortable. They want to be able to breathe. And they want to be where they can get something to eat.
Oh, geez, and I got this going here. Sorry, Tim.
You better grab a net.
Where are you, Tim? Where's the net? Oh, God. He's heavy. Attaboy. Attaboy, Tim.
Red chartreuse. Look what a belly. That's a fat bottom girl
there.
Oh, fat bottom girl.
We just moved too, eh?
Pretty fish.
Yeah, man. I'm going to do the honors. You see? You fish with the right guy, you get to hold a fish too. But I promise you, sooner or later, that's going to happen. Like all thick. Look at that. Wow. We're going to let her go. We're going to take some pictures of some of these fish. Look at the backs too, how nice and thick. Just a gorgeous fish, gorgeous fish. Got a little scar on her. We're going to put her in a live well and let her go in a bit. Thank you, big girl, making our day. The sun finally comes out, but it's still cold. And we're wondering, are they going to bite? They start biting.
Oh, looky here, baby. On a jig.
Left him in, all right?
Bring him on in. Looky here.
Oh,
come over here, brother.
You see, swing and a miss, huh? I didn't miss that one. I mean, is that the same one?
Yep.
Same one came back.
Same one nibbled on the other pole.
Grabbed, hit my little B&M one. He's just a small one. But a little female, maybe, hey?
Yeah, female.
Little female. Going back. You know what that is? My first Washington crappie that I caught. 2014. God, I love you, crappie. You ready to go back? Huh? Ready to go back? Tell mama to come on over, bite the left side of the boat, okay? Go on. Bye. Catch and release for the future. Let's go. Man, does it feel nice. Tim's getting them. I'm getting them. He's getting poles that are pulling to the left, pulling to the right, pulling down, you name it. Lake Washington is where it's at.
You know, under cold conditions, we had to alternate our pattern from what we normally do. We're normally trolling pretty fast. We had to slow our presentation down. You know, we had to actually get down to a slow grind and position our baits at different depths. Not real deep, but we had some maybe 30 inches on the surface and some 12 inches on the surface.
Because all I'm looking at is that rod. Is it going to bounce? Is it going to the left? Going to go to the right? Is it going to come up? Everything else stops. All I'm looking at is that pole and a big crappie. Looks like a good one. Looks like a good one. Attaboy, Black Lee. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Look at that, eh? Crappie. White crappie. Ooh, he's got it, too. Just right through the jig, around the glove, in the glove. Talk about pandemonium. That's what you got right there. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Pearl, beautiful, cold water crappie. Gonna go in the live well with the other couple we got. We'll let them go, take some pictures. But some of these be good for eating. You know, they're not full of eggs. We'll have a little fish fry. Let's put her in there. Ready to go in there? Your friends are waiting. You wanna go in? I like the way she drunk it like that. You still see a little mark on her hook. The hook went in, bang. Those are the bites you like. Go on. Because those are the bites you rarely miss. Even if I didn't see the bite, Tim, get him! Boom, he got it good. So maybe that sun just inspired them a little bit more, and just trigger effect to start biting more so we can catch him. So next time you come to Lake Washington, you are gonna catch him. Little Rosie, oh, fingers are just froze. That little minnow, barely through the lips. Look how small that is. You gonna catch me a big fish or a small fish? As long as it's any fish. Let's see. Double minnow rig, jig, jig, jig. Which one's gonna get bit? Jig's been hot, eh?
Wash today.
Atta boy, Tim. Atta boy, Tim.
Jig fell out in the net.
Did it?
Yep.
Oh boy. Whoo, lordy. That's why we come to Lake Washington, huh? That's the deal today. Look at that thing. Look at those fins, eh? I said it before, I say it again. Just look at that fins, man. That's where all that power is when we're swimming. Everywhere, boy. The back, big yap. Well, she's gonna join her friends for a short swim, for some pictures. We made it on TV. Well, as you can see, we're not catching a lot. And it's water's only like 47 degrees. But the sun's come out, we're warming up a bit. Tim perseveres, moves around different spots. You know, if you don't get him in 8, 9 feet, moving into 7. He made a comment that if we don't get him in this 9, we're gonna go a little bit deeper and try. But different depths, alter it, adapt, and you'll catch him. Like us on Washington or anywhere else, crappie swim in a cold front. Let's keep going, hopefully get some more.
You know, we've altered our pattern. Finally, we're catching some good sized fish and 2+ pounds. That's what Lake Washington is known for. And that's what we started catching.
Wind just changed direction.
Uh-huh.
Maybe I'll make them bite.
God, no. God, what a monster crappie, boys and girls. That dude hit like he weighed 15 pounds. Oh, man. What a hit. Oh, he ain't that.
Your rod scream?
He ain't no giant, but my goodness, he was mad.
Oh, you good fish, man. Good fish, Tim.
Another 2+.
In the box?
2+.
Not a bad average, huh? Beautiful fish. Put them in there, keep going. Looking for more and more. Average like that, boy. Anywhere across the states, it's pretty good fishing.
We saved the best and biggest for last. You gotta watch this next segment as some of Lake Washington's biggest slabs come to play.
When Tim called me and told me about this new lake in Mississippi called Lake Washington, I thought, wow, I never even heard of it, never even saw it. No research, nothing on the internet, but it did not disappoint. I saw some of the pictures at that small bait shop before we launched the boat. Phenomenal. I was really looking forward to it.
You know, Carl and I had plans to come to Mississippi to fish Grenada, and I called him about 2 weeks earlier and said, hey, you know, Lake Washington and Greenville, Mississippi is on fire. They're catching 3-pounders, catching big stringers there a lot. And I asked him if he wanted to try to make that trip. He said, yes, let's make it happen. He showed up, went to Lake Washington, and it was on.
We get all this put together. You know, temperature has really cooled off down here for southern Mississippi. So I don't know really what to expect. I know they've been catching some giant fish here at Lake Washington. So maybe when the water warms up and the temperature warms up a little bit, we'll be able to hook up on some big ones. But we might have to change our tactics a little bit. Slow down since it's cooled up. We'll see. We'll see what the day brings.
I know what you're thinking. Big winter coat, long pants, etc. Supposed to be warm in the south, right? But you know what? At home, today, snowstorm, wind, sleet, freezing rain, everything nasty. So I ain't complaining, because I know what? Today it's gonna get to about 65 degrees here, like Florida for me.
You know, we got to Lake Washington, was in pre-spawn. I knew the fish hadn't spawned yet. So, you know, we wasn't gonna be fishing really shallow, like a foot or two. I knew we was gonna back off, and we did. We started fishing, and we found the fish actually holding in about 8 to 9 foot of water. And once we really got concentrated in the area, about 100-yard stretch where these big females were pre-spawn in a holding pattern, we really started catching some big ones.
See, this is one of the most exciting times of the day for me, setting up. We're gonna catch big crappie, small crappie, any crappie, picking the right colors, the right bait, presentation. Put all the pieces together, and hopefully, by the end of the day, when we sit down for lunch or dinner, we got us a mess of crappie. but it's putting the pieces together to make a real good cake. And today, I want it to be my birthday cake. Bake. Let's see. It's a brand new color.
We'll try different colors, and we'll see which one they bite, and then we can go to, you know, we figure it out, we'll go to one color. Right now, we're, you know, it's early in the morning. We've had a cold front come through, so we're just kind of experimenting. See which one they want to bite.
And how deep are you going to put them?
We'll stage them different depths.
Okay.
Put one, you know, this show's 9 foot, so let's put one about 7, one about 5, and one about 3.
And pick a lucky color?
Pick whatever you want.
Okay.
Dang. Oh, he's on there, dummy. Good one.
Oh, boy.
Good net.
Oh. Where'd you? Oh, boy. Holy cow. It's a good one. I was watching that net. Look at that, hey? Look at that. Let's show him the net, Tim, how he looks like. Look at that crappie, hey?
That's what we are.
Look at the belly on that fish, buddy. Okay, that's love, man. Let's get that hog in the net. Wow. He's got some girth and weight to him too, doesn't he?
That big fat belly, that's a big female.
We'll take pictures of those and let them go.
See,
maybe after.
She's got eggs coming out of her.
Yeah.
She's getting ready to lay.
Wow.
Fish. Beautiful fish.
Beautiful fish. Beautiful slab, man. Nice going, buddy. See what happens? Crappy masters. Masters.
Pretty fish.
Yeah.
We're going to put him in a live well for pictures, and then we're going to put him back in a little bit. A lot of these fish are, when we get the trigger, the bites, they just take off. I mean, you know, they're wild and they take off at a sideways run. The natural reaction is take your pole if it's running sideways and pull it against them. But you'll always just about all the time miss that fish, because when you're pulling it out the side of his mouth. You got to pull straight up on that fish.
Yeah.
And as many times as I know in my mind what I'm supposed to do, it's just hard not to keep try to overcorrect that fish, and you're
right.
Not going to catch that fish.
Yep.
You got to come straight up with that hook set every time. But you know, you can get away with it as a smaller fish, but these bigger fish with their mouths so tender and they have such a mass and so much weight and so powerful with their fins and tail, you know, if you don't get it in the meat part, the bone part of the, you know, they're going to rip it out.
Yep. It's like Mother Nature gives them that. The bigger I get, the more chances I have to come free.
Sure.
You know?
And like I've always said, they don't get big by being dummies. I mean, they know. They know when they suck that jig in there and it don't feel right, they go spit it out just about immediately.
Yep.
Fish.
This one?
Get him. You buggy whipped him again.
Yes. And it's a good one too, isn't he?
Good one.
He's a good one.
Got him.
Yeehaw! Mountain Dew. Oh, he's nice, isn't he?
Good
oh my
fish.
Goodness. But I did buggy whip him, didn't I?
You buggy whipped him. You're lucky you got him. You got him in that hard part of the mouth.
Oh, look at that bounce out. That was fate, that one, wasn't it? First one for me in Mississippi in 2013. Look at the belly again. Again, like Tim said earlier with the other fish, you can take some nice pictures, let these fish go, because it's just a fantastic resource to make us happy, feed us, but you gotta respect it, seriously. Let some of the bigger females go. You're gonna catch all kinds of males and smaller fish. They're great to eat, but think about the future. But for you, hey, little fatty, you go in the live well for a while, and they'll let you go, okay? Beautiful. Here's your goat.
But you gotta make sure that you keep pressure.
Get it out of there and keep it going, right.
Because these bigger fish, as soon as they get an opportunity, they gone because they know what's up.
Yes.
They don't get big by being dummies.
See, that's for all you at home to think it's real easy, right? You see all the poles and you think, wow, it's not easy. You got to put everything together, man. But when you do it, the feeling of accomplishment is awesome when you're laying in that basket net. And like you say, we catch the big females, they're great for pictures. Let them go and let them have a future. So it's always good. But that's a testament to having all the right setup, right spot, right equipment, speed.
You know, we've changed poles through the years that we fish. We went with these B&M graphite jig poles, and they're a lot flimsier. And one thing that does, especially when you're down here in Mississippi fishing for these big fish, you know, if you got resistance, just like I was talking about earlier with that heavy jig, if you got that resistance of that pole when they pull down, they spit it out immediately.
Right.
And you know, with these flimsy poles, you made a mention, you know, how they were moving in the wind.
Yeah.
Well, what that does, that keeps that fish from feeling the weight of that pole tip. I mean, these pole tips are really flimsy, and it keeps that pole, that fish from feeling, you know, that mm-hmm. stiffer pole.
Right.
Fish. Oh, whoa. Come here, mama dog.
Big dog?
Oh, oh. That's a pretty good one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Atta boy, Tim. Oh, yeah.
Ain't no giant.
Oh, he's a good one.
Pound 3/4 fish.
Are we getting spoiled?
Lake Washington. Beautiful fish.
Yes, man. That excitement, the adrenaline rush. Catching nice crappie. Gotta love it.
You know one thing that always fascinates me, I tell you, fishing with Tim or Kyle or Jackie, it's just that professionalism to how to find crappie. It's just like the KVDs and Hackneys of the world. They just got it dialed in. It doesn't matter what lake it is, what technique or presentation. If there's crappie there, they're going to find them.
Just learning that, you know, it's been a long winter for me getting a 14 or 16 foot rod set and then lean to be able to pull back to net in. The real system to it, boy. It can be frustrating for guys who don't know. It's
boy. You know, a 14-foot pole is hard to handle. But when you go to a 16-foot pole, and today, you know, we was fishing waters that was eight and a half foot deep. We was fishing 6-7 foot deep. You know, you got a 16-foot pole, and you got 6-7 foot of line out. You know, it's hard to get that fish back into
the pole. Yeah,
man. You got a 10-foot net. Get it. Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah.
He's a monster.
Look at him.
Get the net. Get him in the net, baby. Oh, I can't get it. Oh, yeah.
Hey.
Whoa.
Get out, crappie.
Look at that, baby.
Oh, my goodness, Tim. That's a big one, isn't it?
You made up for it. Look what a fish.
Yes.
He's mad, too.
Yes. Got him in a good spot, too, eh? Mm-hmm. There's out. Thank you, sir. Put that back in here. He was mad.
Look
at that,
fish.
Eh?
Man,
oh man. Now you know why I come to Mississippi. I can't beat it, man. Tim, another female, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, we'll take some pictures, like you said. Let these beauties go. They can go back and make some more babies. Oh, Lordy. Wow, look at the thickness of that back. Look at that. It's almost like a bass. Look at it. Big mouth on him. Pulling that minnow. But I was lucky. I got him in the hard spot. You get him in the soft spot and they break your heart. You know why? Because they come off. Get him in the hard spot, they come in the boat.
Here we go, folks. Man your positions. Look for bites. Grab your poles. We're back on the roll.
Look at the conditions. Really. Rolling. It's like a smallmouth kind of day, throwing a jerk bait or spinner bait. But we're out here catching crappie. Can easy turn around, put the boat on the trailer and say, forget it. Nope. We're here to hunt some crappie. We're gonna catch some crappie and we're gonna eat some crappie. So persistence in this case is gonna pay off. But again, all about having the right equipment, putting it all together. Let's keep going.
I'm gonna take that mini rig up, put that other jig out fish.
Oh! On a minnow rig too? Nope, jig.
Man, why am I missing it? That was a good bite too. Dang. That was a good hook set. It was a good bite. I should have had that fish. There he is. Come back and eat anyway.
Hey, look at it. Another plate.
Blackie. I missed that fish on that other hook, on that other jig, and he come back and ate the double minnow rig with a pink and black on it. Little stub, little shed pole, new bait. He eat it too.
It's a good one. Real nice one. Wow. You all swim in there for Tim.
Come back.
Teamwork. Got all the rods set up, and you're catching them. Look at that crappie. That gorgeous looking fish. Gorgeous. Purple sheens and green. Big eyes. Don't worry, you're going back. You're giving us a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
You know, we played around with different speeds today, but 0.2, 0.3 was where we got our triggered our bites. And it seems like a lot of the times we would be sitting still, have our power poles down, and then we'd pick them up, we'd start using our drift paddle. Get him. Oh!
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Got a whole tub here.
Real good one.
Good one.
Oh, hitting the rod.
Got him.
Oh, Lordy. Huh? It went slack, Tim.
I saw it. Look what a fish.
Wow, man.
Whooping them back, boys.
Look at that.
Whooping them.
Look at that. You talk about keeping the tension on. Tim gave me a verbal spanking. Look
man,
at that.
What a pretty fish. Woo.
I love crappie. Isn't that a plate?
Beautiful.
Hey?
Beautiful.
Wow. Look at the mouth. Tell me that thing can't eat. Big, thick back. Look at that thing, man. Beautiful. Big fins. To me, they look so much like big saltwater fish. You know, the big fins and pearl. Live well pictures and a good old release. Thank you, Mississippi. Because you know why? Mississippi produces mutant-sized crappie. Because that's what that is. That's a mute. In the box. Go visit your girlfriends. That one, I didn't miss. You know what I seen, Tim? I seen slack go like this. Thunk, and stay slack. He showed me 2-3 years ago how, no matter what it is, grab the rod. You know, they always talk about it in bass fishing. Swing and miss, who cares? But you just gotta get the train of the eye. You know, it's been a long winter. I've been home, you know. But getting out there and trying not to miss those bites by paying attention, watching it, even in the wind, catching crappie. Love it. Let's keep going.
Good job.
Awesome, man.
You know, once we got dialed in, we found this 100-yard stretch that was holding these big sows getting ready to spawn. And we had to concentrate on that area, and it was a certain speed. You know, 0.3 on my GPS is where these fish were triggering the bite. So we had to concentrate on staying at that speed. And if it wasn't for those power poles and those paddles, it'd been real difficult on a windy day when the wind was blowing 20 to 25 mile an hour.
Beautiful. Big, fat slabs.
Under worst conditions.
Yes.
Cold front come through, hard east wind. I mean, the wind's supposed to blow out of the northeast, which is bad enough, but it's due east.
Yes. Somebody said fishing out of the east, the fishing's the least. They never came to Mississippi, did they? But again, like Tim says, putting the right presentation together with the power pole and the rods. These are 16-foot rods, so they're all a little bit ways. And we're going with the wind, so there's no slapping. I learned all this stuff, you know that? Watching Tim over the last few years. One day, I'll have a rig like this. We'll see.
Good one.
Atta boy. I'm on this side of you. Where are you? See?
There ain't no real good on these.
Oh, he's a crappie. And he's a slabby. Look at that minnow sticking out of his mouth.
It's on no fire tire, pink kid.
It's a crappie. You got him in the boat. That's what matters, Tim.
He's in the boat.
Yes, sir. Do the pleasures. Oh, shaking like a bass. You know, you're doing pretty good. When those look kind of, I shouldn't say small, but smaller, anywhere, that's a good crappie. But in Mississippi, just not big enough, but you're a good fish for slabs. Look at that. Nice big fillet eating fish. Look at the big tail on that thing. You wonder where to get those power, eh? Those power runs. Look at all the fins. Nice. And the excitement when you see that big thing, eh? Starts thrashing on the surface and you think, oh my God, got to get him in. But sometimes it's worse trying to rush him.
Yeah.
Eh?
Main thing, you know, you just got to keep that tension on the pole. Keep, you know,
gotta keep attention on that fish work, because he flops and gets that loose.
Yes.
He don't throw it out of his mouth.
Yeah.
You know, they're similar. These big crappie, like you saw today, they all come to the top, and they're similar to a bass. You know, they're gonna come to the top. They're gonna move that head around and try to throw that big jig out of the mouth. A lot of them were successful today too.
Yeah, man.
You saw us lose some fish, and saw us miss some fish. So, you know, it's definitely a challenge. It ain't, you just don't throw a bunch of poles out here and go fishing and catch a bunch of fish every time.
Exactly. So true. It sure is fun, man. Real fun. Good one?
No. Boy, he's a fighter though. Man, look at him cut up. Man, he's man. Come on here, Jimbo. Get in the daggum net.
Man, Jim,
man.
Still a good crappie, man. Look at that thing. You know, we're getting spoiled, because look at that. I guess that was all right. Did he eat it? He gobbled it. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Show that right inside there, Tim. I fished a lot of places for a lot of species in my life, man. From saltwater, you name it. Everything from bass, pike, etc. Something about that critter that's about that big, but in this case, Mississippi, like that big, that fat, that just inspires me to keep wanting to come back. I want to see more. I want to see what potentially what I can catch, but it's the excitement, anticipation. It's just an amazing little critter that inspires the masses to want to fish for them, catch them, eat them, and just have fun. Let's go. You know, we did see a bunch of boats around us today, and a lot of guys coming and going, right?
Yeah.
Running around. They couldn't hold on. Didn't have the power poles. Couldn't hold right there.
You know, that's one thing. We fished all this time. We drag chains and throw out, wind socks and drag those. But man, these power poles with that drift paddle, man, it made huge difference today.
Yeah.
And, you know, like you said, there was a lot of boats around us, but I didn't see anybody catch as many fish as what we caught today.
No, we got some nice ones, man. Oh, big one.
Oh,
boy. Tim, look at the size of this thing.
Don't lose it.
Yo, baby. Uh-oh. That's going to push 3 pounds, baby.
Come on. Really?
3 pounds.
Oh, my goodness, man.
I'll push it.
The line went screaming, Tim. Screaming. Like, oh man, you got these custom jigs. They are a killer. Look at that. He was never coming out, was he? Oh, wow. Let's put that away over here. Let's have a look at the slab. Tim, you know what, buddy? I've been watching you raise your lines up a bit, and I raised that up. Look at that. Seriously, how big is that crappie?
That's sick.
Hey?
Let's check it. See how close we got. Get him down here. We don't want him to flop over. .275. 2¾ pounds.
Look at that thing,
look,
man.
Look at a hole.
Let me look at that again.
In his mouth. Look at that.
Wow. My biggest crappie of my life. Seriously, look at it. Look how big that is. Even compared to my head, how wide it is, how thick the back is. Oh yeah, man, that is truly amazing. What a specimen.
Freak. It's a freak.
It is. I never thought any species, you know, if you followed me on my shows, I never thought of any species that could inspire me to go fishing more than bass, but these things, they're right there. Let's put her in there, let her swim. Wow, it's a critter. Go on, girl. Right
that's
on.
That's a big one.
Oh, woo. Oh, wow.
Then all of a sudden, Carl's rod tip went down, and he said, I got a good one. And I looked over there, and it looked like a hubcap in the water. And I run and got the net, and we scooped it up, and it was a monster. It was the biggest fish he'd caught in his life, weighed 277. It was a special moment.
Holy moly.
Do you think Lake Washington's on fire
Oh,
now?
Man. I'd say. Oh boy, talk about excitement. Big crappie, Lake Washington, my biggest of my life. 277, almost 3 pounds crappie. That's like a bass. I can't wait to come back.
On a calm day. We missed
almost probably as many as we caught.
Yeah.
But that, I mean, that goes along with fishing for big fish, you know. If we would have wanted to fish for small fish, we'd have had a hook and a minnow and, you know, been not fishing with bigger baits like we was. But, you know, we were looking for big fish and big bites, and that just goes along with catching big fish. You're
yes,
gonna
sir.
Miss some of them.
Yep. Hunting down the big ones. And it's worth it, you know.
You know, just like the .2 to .3 speed, I mean, you got to find those little tricks that makes the difference in your technique and the guy next to you is just trolling, you know, keeping a steady speed to say 0.5 or 0.4.
Yeah.
Today it was just that little trigger that when we stopped and when we took off and reached that speed, it triggered that bite immediately.
Yes.
Oh, whoa!
That thing fight.
Oh man.
You got a horse?
I got a big one. I'm tangled
nice
up.
Oh boy. Oh God.
There ain't no giant, oh, he's good one.
He's nice. He's nice.
Man, that dude here went berserk.
Look where you got him too.
Nice fish.
Yes.
See, I caught him in the side, probably didn't get a good hook set on him. They really kicked up on it. Black chartreuse.
Yes, sir. Wow. What a crappie. Very nice. Very nice.
Beautiful.
That's how we do it.
Man, that dude hit hard.
Look how he looks, eh? Show him over here, Tim. Look at him. Gorgeous. Love it. It's almost time to fill our bellies, isn't it?
Almost time. We've had a good day.
Yeah, man.
Great day. They told us Lake Washington was on fire, and it's on fire.
On fire. This is fantastic. Fantastic fishery. A little while longer, and we're going to have some grub. Well, that was something else. Lake Washington used to be the best kept secret for these boys in Mississippi. Not anymore. This lake is alive with lots of fish, big fish, and some giants. Listen, on behalf of Tim and myself, thanks for watching, and we're going to see you next time. Told you, Old Miss has some absolute monster crappie. Please post your comments below and subscribe to our channel and follow us on Facebook and Instagram as well. Thanks for watching.